In this video, I am going to discuss about net present value. This is a present value calculation technique which considers cash inflows and cash outflows from the start to the end of the project. Depending on the net value of the present values, decisions can be made whether to accept a project or to reject a project. NPV is the superior technique in management accounting because NPV is the representation of the changes to the shareholder wealth of a company by accepting a project. This NPV technique will be used frequently in the next levels as well. In the context of business and financial, the NPV is also used heavily. These are the assumptions for NPV calculation. You need to have a thorough understanding about these assumptions. Only consider cash items. There are non-cash items as well. These are some non-cash items: depreciation, amortization. These types of non-cash items will have an effect on business activities. But these are not real cash flows. These are accounting cash flows. So for NPV calculations, we do not consider non-cash items. We only consider the cash items. Cash inflows consider as positive amounts. Cash outflows consider as negative amounts. Which means if it is a cash inflow, we consider them as positive values. If it is a cash outflow, we consider them as negative values. These negative values also denotes by parentheses, which means we can use parentheses instead of the minus value. Like, let's say 2000 cash outflow. So this can be represented as this. Any transaction happens during a year will be considered as occurred at the end of that year unless otherwise specified. Let's say there is a transaction happen during the year 1. So we consider that transaction at the end of the first year unless otherwise specified. Any transaction occurs at the beginning of a year will be considered as occurred at the year end of the previous year. Let's say there is a transaction happen at the beginning of year 2. So we consider that transaction at the end of the first year. Time period 0 or year 0 means at the very beginning of the investment or project. This is very important because students get confused with time period 0 or year 0. Let me explain. Year 0 or the time period 0 means right now or the very beginning of the investment. Time period 1 or year 1 means after 12 months of investment or project started, which means after completing the 12 months. This is the very beginning of the investment, which is year 0. After completing 12 months, we consider as the first year. NPV is an absolute value where this is used to measure the changes to the shareholder wealth. If NPV is a positive value, shareholder wealth is increasing. On the other hand, if the NPV is negative, shareholder wealth is decreasing. This is the formula we used to calculate the net present value. You know this formula already. We discussed this in the previous lesson. This is the formula for discounting. We use the same formula to calculate the net present value because net present value is the summation of the present values. In order to find the present values, we need to discount the future values into the present value. So capital P is the present value. Capital F is the future value. R is the discount rate. N is the number of years. As you know, this is the discount factor. This can be also write like this: F times 1 plus R into the power minus N. This is the discount factor. We can find the discount factor for given discount rate and the number of year using the present value table. Let's do this example. These are the transactions will be happening during a project. Year 0, negative 3000, which means this is a cash outflow. Year 1, 1200, this is a positive value, this means a cash inflow. Again, year 2, there is a positive value, 1400, this is also a cash inflow. Now we have to calculate the present value for each transaction separately. So the discount rate is given here as 4%. There is very important thing to know about discounting factor for year 0. For year 0, discounting factor is 1. Let me explain to you this by using the discounting factor formula. So the discounting factor formula equals to 1 over 1 plus r into the power n. This is the discounting factor. So year 0, what will happen? 1 over 1 plus r is 4, so 4 over 100 n. So now n will be 0, because the year 0 means at the very beginning of the project, or we can consider this as right now. So the n is equal to 0. So what will happen is 1 over this whole denominator will equal to 1 because of this 0 power. This will equal to 1. So the discount factor for year 0 is 1. So always remember, when you are calculating net present value, the discount factor for year 0 is 1. So the discount factor for year 0 will be 1, no matter what is the discount rate is. So the present value for year 1 is negative 3000. You need to have these parentheses if this is a negative value. Now let's find out the discount factor for year 1. This is the present value table. This is the discount rate, 4%. For year 1, it will be 0.962. This is the discount factor, 0.962. So 0.962. Let's find the discount factor for year 2. So for the year 2, this is the year 2. So this is the discount factor, 0.925. Now we can multiply the cash flow and the discount factor in order to find the present value. So the present value for year 1, 1154.4. This is a positive value. For year 2, the present value is 1295. So now we can calculate the net present value. So the net present value equals to the summation of these present values. So it will be negative 3000 plus 1154.4 plus 1295. This equals to minus 550.6. This is the net present value, which is a negative value. It can be a negative value, it can be a positive value, it can be also zero. Now let's discuss about decision making using NPV values. Positive NPV value. Present value of income of the project is higher than the present value of the cost of the project. Accept projects with positive NPV values. This is very important. If the NPV value for a project is positive, we accept these projects because the present value of the income of this project is higher than the present value of the cost of this project, which means this will increase the shareholder wealth. Zero NPV. Present value of the income and the present value of the cost of the project is equal. no point of accepting a project with zero NPV. This is where the present value of cost and present value of income is equal. There is no point of accepting these types of projects. Negative NPV. Present value of income is lower than the present value of cost of project. Rejects projects with negative NPV values. Which means if the NPV is negative for a project, we reject these projects because these will reduce the shareholders' wealth. Negative NPV means the present value of the cost are higher than the present value of the income. So this will make losses. And very important thing to note is that if all the projects have positive NPVs, select the highest positive NPV project. Because the higher the positive NPV for a project, the higher the shareholders' wealth will be. So always select the highest positive NPV project. Now let's do this example questions. This is question 1, this is question 2, this is question 3. So question 1, year 0 minus 3000, we know the discount factor is 1 because this is the year 0 value. So discount factor is 1. So the present value is minus 3000. For year 1, let's find the discount factor. 4% year 1, which is this value, 0.962. 0.962. For year 2, 0.925. 0.925. For the year 2, present value is 1295. So the NPV equals to negative 550.6. Do we accept this project or not? No, we don't. We reject this project because the NPV is a negative, which means the present value of the income is lower than the present value of the costs. You can identify the income as positive values. These are the incomes. This negative value is the cost. Let's do the second example. So now you know the discount factor is 1. So this will be 1400 negative. Now let's find out the discount factor for year 1. Now the discount rate is 6%. So the 6% is here. Year 1 is here. 0.943. 0.943. For year 2, 0.890. 0.890. So the NPV for this project is positive 511.4. Do we accept or reject this project? We accept this project. This will increase the shareholder wealth. Now let's do the third example. So the discount factor for year 0 is 1. So this will be minus 3000. 9% is here. For year 1, this is the discount factor. 0.917. 0.917. For year 2, this is the value for year 2. Now look at the given cash flows for this example. There are two cash outflows. This can happen. Projects will do not always have this type of cash flows because the cash inflows and the cash outflows can happen without any pattern during a project. So don't worry about negative and positive cash flows during a project. Just calculate each present value for each transaction. Then calculate the net present value for this project. If the NPV is positive, we can accept that project. If the NPV is negative, we can reject that project. If the NPV is zero, there is no point taking that project because that will not increase the shareholder wealth and it will not decrease the shareholder wealth as well. Now let's complete the third example question. This is 1178.8. So now we can calculate the NPV. So the NPV for this project is negative 2004.6. So we reject this project. Typically, the first cash flow of a project will be a negative one, because we have to invest or we have to use the capital in order to start the project. So if the question is saying that if we are investing or we are using the capital for a project, which means it is a negative value, be mindful to use that amount as a negative value. Now let's do this example. Here it says we have to select the project that will maximize the shareholder wealth. Here are the NPV values for each project. -10,000, -550, 0, +20, +50, -15,000. So the answer is F, right? Because this is the highest value. Is it? No, it is incorrect, because we do not accept the negative NPV projects. Negative NPV means it's a loss, because the present value of the income is lower than the present value of the costs. So we can reject all the negative NPV projects. Project A, Project B, and Project F. So reject negative NPV projects. Doesn't matter the numerical amount. Higher the numerical amount of a negative NPV project, which means the higher the loss. So now let's consider answer C, D, E. As now we know, zero NPV project has the present value of the income and the present value of the costs to be equal to each other, which means no point of accepting this project, because this will not increase the shareholder wealth. Now we have positive 20 and positive 50. As the final answer, we can choose the positive 50, because this is the highest positive NPV. 20 is also a positive value, but 50 is higher than the 20. So we can choose the answer E, which will maximize the shareholder wealth. Accept positive NPV projects and select the highest positive NPV project. Zero NPV project, no point. Now you have a thorough understanding about the NPV technique. This will be used frequently in the next levels as well as in the real business and financial world. Now let's go one step further under NPV technique. Relevant costs and irrelevant costs. We discussed about these in an early video. Now let's see how are the relevant costs and irrelevant costs will be considered under NPV technique. For NPV technique, only relevant cash flows will be considered. This is very important. Always remember, under NPV technique, we only consider relevant cash flows. So what are the relevant cash flows? Relevant cash flows are future incremental cash flows which will incur as a direct result of an investment decision, which means we have to consider all the future incremental cash flows under NPV technique. These can be cash inflows as well as cash outflows. As long as these are relevant, we have to consider under NPV technique. So these are the relevant costs. These are very important. Have a good understanding about the following points. Resale value or scrap value. These are the resale value of an asset or scrap value of a machine. Let's say you bought a mobile phone today for, let's say, $1,000. In 6 months' time, you can sell this mobile phone. It will be lower than $1,000. Let's say for $400. This is the value of resale, or we can consider this as scrap value. In the future, you will receive this amount when you resell your phone. So this is a future incremental cash flow. So this is a relevant cost. When it comes to NPV technique, we have to consider the resale value or scrap value. Next one is the incremental costs, an increase or decrease in future cash flows. For an example, wages for temporary staff. These are the cash flows which will be increased or decreased based on the decisions. Let's say you have to hire temporary staff. This will increase your cost to the business. So this is an incremental cost. So you have to consider these costs under NPV technique. Let's say now you don't need the temporary staff. So this will decrease the costs. These cost savings will also be considered under NPV technique. Opportunity costs, or this is also known as lost contribution. Cost of losing the next best opportunity. Under NPV technique, you are not required to calculate any of these costs. These will be given. You have to decide whether these costs are relevant or not. And using the relevant costs, you will have to calculate the NPV value. Opportunity cost is where, let's say you have lumber or wood in your house. You can use this lumber and wood for different purposes. There will be more than few options. Let's say the best option is to make a table from this lumber. And the next best option is to make a chair from this lumber. If you decide to make a table with this wood, you will lose the opportunity to make a chair. That is the opportunity cost. Opportunity cost is where losing the next best opportunity. So when it comes to NPV technique, opportunity costs are relevant. So we will consider these costs under NPV calculations. Avoidable costs. As the name suggests, these costs can be avoidable. As examples, wages, material cost. You can decide to lay off your staff. This will save your cost because this is an avoidable cost. Or you can decide to buy less material for the next month. These avoidable costs will be considered under NPV technique. All these costs are future incremental cash flows. Now let's discuss about what are the irrelevant costs. These costs will be not considered under NPV technique. Meaning that if you come across these costs under NPV technique, just ignore them. We are not going to consider these under NPV calculations. Sunk costs. Costs that have already incurred and non-recoverable. Also known as non-refundable costs. Let's say you need to buy a phone, but you don't have enough time to research for a phone because you are studying for CIMA. So what you do is you pay one of your friends $5 to research on a mobile phone, aligning with your requirement. So you already paid the $5. This $5 will be non-recoverable or non-refundable. Meaning, whether you decide to buy a phone or not, your friend will not refund this money. These are called the sunk costs. Under NPV technique, we do not consider sunk costs. So when you come across sunk costs under NPV technique, just ignore them. Do not include them in the calculations. Committed costs, wages for permanent staff. As the name suggests, these costs you have to be committed to. Like paying your permanent staff. Every month you have to pay the wages. So committed costs also ignored under NPV technique. Allocated costs. These are the costs that incur for the whole organization. For an example, energy. Let's say electricity bill. These allocated costs are also not relevant under NPV technique. These allocated costs are also ignored under NPV calculations. Lastly, non-cash items such as depreciation amortization. These will be ignored because these are non-cash items. Let's go back to the definition of relevant costs. Here, it should be future, incremental and cash flows. This is very important. Cash flow. So, non-cash items will be ignored. This means these have monetary value, but these are not real cash flows, such as depreciation amortization. So, when you come across non-cash items, these will be ignored under NPV calculations. Depreciation is where, let's say, you buy a mobile phone today for $1,000. And in 6 months' time, you will sell this phone, let's say $600. What is the difference between these two monetary values? This is the effect of depreciation. Because as the time goes by, the value of the assets will be decay as you use them. This is a non-cash item. Now let's do this example, so you will have a better understanding of how to tackle a question. Company A is considering an initial investment of $50,000 for a new project, and the project will return $12,000, $13,000, $15,000 in year 1, year 2, year 3 respectively. A research cost of $1,000 was paid to a research firm. The machinery for the project will depreciate by $500 annually. Annual wages for the staff is $15,000. At the end of the year 3, the machinery can be sold for $3,000. If the discount rate is 6%, calculate the NPV for the project and will they accept the project or not. So there are two requirements: to calculate the NPV and what will be the decision of the company about this project. So let's read the question again and identify what are the relevant costs and what are the irrelevant costs. Remember that we are going to use the NPV technique. Company A is considering an initial investment of $50,000. This $50,000 is relevant because this is the initial investment. So, year 0, cash outflow of $50,000. So, what is the discount factor? Discount factor is 1 because this is the initial investment or year 0. So, this equals to negative 50,000. Now, let's continue. For a new project, and the project will return 12,000, 13,000, and 15,000 in year 1. 2 and 3 respectively. These are future incremental cash inflows. So these are relevant to the NPV calculation. So year 1 cash inflow 12,000. This is a positive value. Year 2 13,000. This is also a positive value. Year 3 15,000. Let's continue again. A research cost of $1,000 was paid to a research firm. Is this relevant or not? This is not relevant because this is a sunk cost. Because they have already paid this amount, the company will not recover this amount. The machinery for the project will depreciate by $500 annually. Is this amount relevant or not? This is not relevant because this is depreciation. This is a non-cash item. So, we will not consider this under NPV technique. annual wages for the staff is 15,000. Is this cost is relevant or not? This is also not relevant. Why? This is a committed cost. This is committed because the company has to pay this amount. They are committed to pay this amount. We do not consider committed cost under NPV technique. At the end of the year 3, the machinery can be sold for $3,000. Is this amount relevant or not? This is a relevant cash flow. Why? This is a future incremental cash inflow. This is the resale value or scrap value. So let's add this value to year 3. Because they are going to sell this machine at the end of the year 3. This is 5. This is a cash inflow, so this is a positive. So we add this to 15,000. Now we have to calculate the NPV value. The discount rate is given 6%. Using the present value table, let's find out the discount factors for year 1, 2, 3. So this is the present value table. Here is the 6% column, and we need the discount factor for year 1, 2, and 3. These are the present values for each transaction. Now let's calculate the net present value. NPV is negative 11,994. This is the NPV value for this project. So will the company accept or reject this project? They will reject this project because NPV is negative. I hope now you have a thorough understanding about the NPV technique. You must have a better understanding of these relevant and irrelevant costs because these will be essential when you are calculating the NPV values. So when it comes to questions, read the question carefully and identify what are the relevant cash flows for the NPV calculation. Now let's discuss about the pros and cons of NPV technique. Pros. Consider the time value of money. This is where the discount factor comes in. As we now know, NPV technique is the superior method when it comes to investment appraisal because it considers the time value of money. Gives an absolute value. As you can see here, this value is an absolute value, meaning this is not a percentage value. We can make decisions based on this value. As we did here, we rejected this project solely based on the NPV value. Easier decision making using NPV value. As I said earlier, we rejected the project simply because the NPV value was negative. Negative NPV value means the project will decrease the shareholder wealth. We don't need that. We need to increase the shareholder wealth. We need positive NPV value projects. Can be used to compare different size of projects. Since NPV is an absolute value, we can compare different size of projects. Cons of NPV technique. NPV value is just an estimate. Discount rate can be changed during the project. The discount rate is an estimate. It means as the project goes on, this can be changed. NPV cannot be guaranteed. Because the discount rate is an estimate, the final NPV value can be changed. So in the reality, the calculated NPV will not be achieved. Cash flow will not always occur at the end of the year. So this is a limitation of the NPV technique as well. In reality, the cash flows will not always occur at the end of the year. It will occur during the year as well. So this is a limitation of NPV technique. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.